So you've actually been to one of these before?
Yeah, I go to them all the time.
She talks big, huh?
Do you want to go or not?
Yeah, right.
Jagger's going.
I don't remember saying that I was going.
Yes, you are. Come on. Raves are a really important part of growing up. They're fun. There's lots of people. You lose all your inhibitions.
I don't know. I don't think my Uncle Mac would let me go. I mean, he'd rather let me go to prom.
Looks like you are on your own.
Oh, great. Look who's here.
I'm going to take this stuff from the back.
Hey, Karen.
Hey. Well, it looks like you scared Jagger away.
How's the job at the hospital going?
Job?
Well, I should be there soon if all goes well.
I'm so excited about my new job at Deception. It's going to be so fun.
Well, if you land it.
Oh, I didn't tell you. I got it.
Can you believe her? I mean, some of us are just born lucky.
What? I wasn't listening.
Are you all right?
Yeah. I'm just a little tired, you know. Having two jobs, it's starting to catch up with me, you know?
Yeah, I understand.
She's so weird.
Well, I better go.
Okay, call me later.
All right.
Okay,
bye.
Jagger, what time is Mike's foster mom coming to see you?
In about an hour. I hope she knows something about where he is.
So do I. Look, I have a good feeling about this, you know?
Thanks.
I hope it works out for you.
Yeah, thanks. Would you like to sit down?
Gee, I didn't mean to cut into your work time.
Oh, no, it's all right, it's all right. I talked to the boss.
Yeah, you're lucky enough to get a job these days. You shouldn't take any chances messing it up.
Do you have a job?
Well, I fill in at the factory when some of the regulars are out sick.
Uh-huh.
See, my husband, he got laid off 2 months ago. That's been rough.
He's got a job now?
Well, he got a lead on some night work at a mill out of town. That's where we were when you tried to get in touch with him. Jeez, you look like Mike. Got the same eyes.
Thanks. I haven't seen Mike in so long. I still see him as a little kid. You know, find him is all I can think about right now. Listen, have you got any phone calls, letters, anything from him lately?
Nothing. Nothing. My husband, he went down to those places where the kids hang out, but if they knew where Mike was, they weren't talking.
Well, listen, maybe they could talk to me. I'm a lot closer to their age. I mean, could you give me some names, anything?
Well, see, whatever friends Mike had, we never met him.
Has he steal anything?
Money.
From you?
Yeah. Geez, I wish we could have gotten through to him. I mean, he has so much going for him. He's very bright and real likable.
You know, I'm glad you feel that way in spite of everything.
You know, whatever happened to him after you and him got separated, I think it made him real angry inside. And he got all these defenses built up. You know, and me and my husband, we just couldn't get his trust, no matter how hard we tried. I'm real sorry.
No. It's great. I really appreciate everything. Listen, could you write down some neighborhood hangouts, anything to think of?
Sure. Well, the video mall, that's for sure. And then there's that punker club where they all hang out. Oh, yeah. Uh-huh.
That's for much older crowds.
Well, yeah, Mike hung out with older kids. That's one thing we know. The school told us that. Have you been to the police?
He's in trouble with the police?
Well, not when he was living with us, but that gang the school mentioned, well, they're always in trouble with the law. Ah, geez, I wish I had something more hopeful to tell you.
Well, listen, it's great, really. I mean, that's a start.
Yeah, well, you know, let me give you my number.
That's great.
And you call me anytime. And if there's anything I find out, I'll get in touch with you, okay?
Listen, let me ask you, do you have any idea how much money Mike stole from you?
Oh, over time, I guess 200-300. But we never reported that to the police, if that's what you're thinking.
No, I You know, I have some money saved. As a matter of fact, I have about 50 with me, but I can send you the rest later. I want to. I really do. I really do. And especially with your husband, you know, out of work, you could use it. And I really want to pay off my debt.
Thanks. I hope you find him. You know, Mike really needs you in his life.
I try. I sure didn't give up.
Good. Because I'm afraid that if someone doesn't set him straight soon, Mike's headed for big trouble.
From what Mike's foster mother told me, Mike is not doing so well.
Sorry you didn't get better news from Mrs. Norton.
Yeah, but at least I got some information. You know, I gotta find him before he goes to juvie, you know?
Have you thought about going to the old neighborhood? Talking to some of the girls, I bet he had a girlfriend.
It's not a bad idea.
Not just a pretty face, you know.
Don't you have an appointment you have to keep?
Oh, God, I completely forgot. I have to go get fitted for deception. Thank you, Ruby.
Anytime.
Oh, okay.
And good luck, okay?
Oh, thanks. Are you going to go look for Mike right now? Yeah. I'm sorry I have to go. I'll be thinking about you, though. Hey, look, if you need my car for anything, I'll be back in a few hours.
Thanks. I mean, thanks for everything, okay?
Well, you do the same for me. Thanks, Ruby. Bye, you guys.
Bye.
Are you going to check out the places Mrs. Norton gave you?
Yeah, I'm going to hit him tonight. I mean, when all the kids are out.
Don't you want to look this afternoon?
I'm just going to be writing a little bit. I don't know if I'm going to find anything, but I'm going to give it a shot.
Oh, I'm sure there's somebody out there who's going to be able to help you.
Except for the lady that came in today. Nobody really wants to give me the time of day. Except there is someone.
Who?
My sister, Gina.
Gina said she doesn't want to see you.
I know, but if I tell them that Mike might be in trouble, I know she would help me. I know she would. Listen, I have to go see her. I'm sorry, okay? I just have...
Wait, hang on, Jagger. You can't go see her.
Well, just watch me, okay?
They have a court order against you. You can't go.
Who cares?
You could get put in jail.
Listen, do us both a favor. Don't pretend you care.
You can't go see her. They have a court order against you.
You think I care about a stupid court order?
You should. They could put you in jail.
Look, Gina might know where Mike is, okay? And besides, what difference does it make if I go to jail?
Hey, stop. Just because we're not together means that I can't care about you anymore. Fine, Jagger. Go. I do not care.
Let's quiet this down. Come on. In the kitchen with this. You're disturbing the entire restaurant. Stop it. Right now. Okay. Get your act together. Be quiet.
You know, if they call the cops on me, then they call the cops on me. There's nothing I can do about it, okay?
You're absolutely right. You're right. Go do it. I don't care. Can you, hand me that bowl, please?
You don't get it, do you?
No, I guess I don't. So let's just end this conversation, okay?
See, Mike is my brother, and he might be in trouble, okay? And when you love somebody, you got to be willing to take a risk for them. But I guess you wouldn't know anything about it, would you?
Look, Jagger, you can take as many digs at me as you want, okay? But this is not about us, this is about you. Mm-hmm. Have you given any thought to the possibility that there might be some other options?
Well, name one.
The telephone? We have telephones.
Oh, great. Yeah. So I call Gina. She picks up the phone, realizes me, then hangs up the phone. Then probably goes talk to her parents. Any more brilliant ideas?
You could call Paul or Scott.
Paul. Scott, yeah. Let's see what they would say. Maybe get one of those go-between to go talk to Gina. Or maybe get an appointment to see that wonderful judge. Remember that wonderful judge so helpful to me?
I don't want you to get in trouble. Don't you understand that?
No, should I? You know, I stood right here. Right in this kitchen. When you told me that I wasn't good enough for you. And that you didn't care anymore for me.
I never said that. I did not say that.
You didn't? Then what did you say?
I said that... We weren't right for each other.
Oh, and let me quote this. You also said that I wasn't fitting in your plans. Well, maybe you should stay out of mine. I'm out of here.
Honey, would you get those dirty dishes down here for me?
Yes, absolutely. Thank you. Addresses for the rave clubs, you know?
Oh, yeah, I've heard about those. Have you ever been to one?
Nope.
I guess I would have fainted dead away if you said yes. I hear they're pretty wild. Okay. I'll be back in a minute.
Okay.